Hi everyone, this is Arcadius and welcome back to Naval Creek. Today we'll be reviewing the very first German cruiser, that being Brummer. But first, before that, let's just take a quick look at the German line in general. So German cruisers are actually pretty powerful, and I would say that they're probably my favorite out of all cruisers. They're just so multi-task useful, I guess you could say. They can adapt to any kind of situation that you need and are kind of a jack-of-all-trades kind of setup. They are known for okay-ish armor. The higher you go, the better it is. However, you are not invincible to citadels by any means. Your guns are pretty good as well. Rapid firing, high shell velocity, good damage as well. Your AA is lacking in the lower tiers, but the higher tier you go, your AA is actually pretty powerful, and most of your ships have torpedoes equipped as well that you can be used. So you start with Brummer, then Dresden as the matchmaking tier 3, or 2, Kolberg, Karlsruhe, Königsberg, Nuremberg, technically Graf Spee is next, but I'm going to do Hipper, and then I'm going to do Graf Spee, Prinz Heinrich, Lean, and then Magdeburg. As you noticed, I have renamed some of these ships, so they're not the ones that are native to this game, but still, they are good nonetheless. So, Brummer. Brummer is actually a really, really large cruiser for Tier 1. It's even larger than the Tier 2, or matchmaking Tier 2, I should say. And it's actually quite similar to Karlsruhe. If you see, there's a very obvious similarity there. So let's take a look to see what we have. We have 7200 health, we have 100 millimeters of armor, so I'm guessing that would be on the conning tower there. It says 40 millimeters of belt armor, so you don't really have any armor. However, it is just enough to shatter high explosive from lower tier guns. So you will actually most likely have to use armor piercing when you're using against the ship. It's not impossible to use high explosive if you aim for the superstructure and the bow on the stern, but that you will find that at some points the armor will be effective. You have 150mm guns, or almost 6-inch guns, 10 rounds a minute, 18 seconds turn time. You can see here the shell velocity is really good. And I'm pretty sure you have the longest range of all Tier 1 cruisers at 13.5 kilometers. That being said, your gun placement is kind of a problem. You have one gun in the bow, one gun in the stern, and then two amidships, and their angles are kind of weird, as you can probably tell by the gun placement. Besides this, that is all it has. There may be a few AA guns. I don't see any off the top of my head here. So it doesn't look like it, and no torpedoes either. So you only have those four guns. Let's see here. Your speed is 20 knots, so you're not necessarily fast either. You do actually have pretty good AA. But at this tier, you're highly unlikely to see any kind of aircraft. So she can be most comparable to something like Erie. In regards of size, of guns, and other aspects. But she is actually pretty good. Now, when I was first playing, I actually really, really hate this ship. And I still don't play it that often. But with the update, where Tier 1 cruisers only face Tier 1 cruisers now, instead of Tier 2 and battleships as well, she actually stands out quite a bit more. With her high-velocity guns, she can stay at ranges that other Tier 1 cruisers can't shoot at. And she has that long range, so she can accurately hit ships from range. And she's nigh invincible, since she can keep the range and not be shot at. And even if she is shot at, she has enough armor to at least mitigate some of that damage. So she is actually really, really powerful. So let's toss her into a game and see what we can do. Alright, and here we have ourselves a game. Got pretty much all the first tier cruisers, so no real need to go through them. But there's Sacerdotes, Eries, Brummers, Black Swans. I think that's actually it. pretty sure that's it. So I do have health buffs and speed buffs applied, so keep that in mind. But you can just see the size difference between something like Hashidate and Brummer. So let's just keep going here. You can see the amidships guns are going to be the most problematic for you. Like I said, the guns are powerful. They just have really strange angles. But once you get past that, then it's no big deal. To use all your guns, it looks like that rear turret has pretty bad angle, something like that. Not that you're going to be dodging or bouncing in most shells. Actually, that third turret angle is even worse. So even then, your angles are, you have to be pretty much broadside to use all four of your guns. Which, if you stay at range, isn't necessarily a problem. So let's just keep going this way. The slow speed of the low-tier cruisers is definitely a change from ships like Des Moines or Baltimore, which I've reviewed recently. Now you can see how I can stay at range and easily take on anything. If you look at the map here, every single ship is already in range by the time the game starts. And if you keep that range, then you don't have to worry about it. Now, I am actually not penning the armor on Erie. I got a pen there. But even then. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to slow down. Keep my angle so I can shoot. Black Swans don't have much armor. I can probably Citadel it from here with high explosive. Yep, there we go. And just keep raking in the damage. You're not going to get big damage numbers by any means. It's a tier 1 match. At this point, probably go for kills. I like to go for damage myself, though. There we go. One down. Next. And this is pretty much how you do it. If you've watched my Yatsen game, it's pretty much just like that. Or even Erie, like I said, is a good indication of how you can play the ship. You just need to stay as far away as you can. In this case, I have double the range of what I need, which is kind of wasted. But if you're in a bad position, or if you're in low health, then you can definitely use it to your advantage. I'm going to switch to armor piercing to see how that is, because I'm getting quite a few shatters on targets. So maybe at range, it's best to use armor piercing. Let's try it. Oh, wow. That was some pretty solid damage. So maybe armor piercing at range is the best for this ship. I mean, high explosive can definitely be useful. And armor piercing, you're still going to get overpens on the wrong targets. But it looks like armor piercing does have its place at this tier. I still shattered. But I one-shot it in the next salvo. I really don't need armor piercing for a black swan, but I'm curious to see what it'll do. Yeah, just overpens. So I switch back to high explosive. And just mop up the rest of these ships. As you can see, if played correctly, this ship can be very, very devastating. Now, that doesn't mean I'm necessarily a fan of her by any means. I still think Black Swan is one of the strongest, if not the strongest, Tier 1 cruiser. And we'll go into why that is when we review her. But Brummer definitely does have her place. And honestly, she is a pretty good introduction to the German cruiser line. You have high shell velocity guns. You have pretty good shells. And okay-ish armor if you know how to use it correctly. But she lacks in other areas. So we did 30,000 damage, 5 ships sunk, 58 shell hits, 10 citadels, 2 fires. almost an exact split between high explosive and armor piercing damage.
So
yeah, that's just basically how the first tier cruiser goes. Next, you would have Dresden and Kolberg, which are pretty similar. They have quite a few 4-inch guns that just rapid fire. Then you go to Karlsruhe, which has the same 150mm guns. I like to call this ship the German railgun. I will go into why when we review her. Then we have Königsberg and Nürnberg, which are both very similar in playstyle, and Nürnberg being one of my favorite ships in this cruiser line. You also have Grasch Bay, which you start seeing 11-inch guns on cruisers. These are almost Scharnhorst-level guns. Then you have Blücher, or Hipper, which is it's kind of like a nerfed Prinzeugen, but she has her place as well. And then you have Prinz Heinrich, you have Lien, and you have Magdeburg. Now, these are the newest cruisers for the German tech tree, and they're actually really powerful. This cruiser itself has two Scharnhorst turrets, really good torpedoes, and the AA at this level is amazing. And then you have Lien, or the O-class, I should say, where you can actually equip 15-inch guns on a cruiser. At that point, I fail to see how she can be a cruiser, but she holds the record for the largest mounted guns for a cruiser class. There's ships like Kronstadt and Alaska that have 12-inch. You have Scharnhorst, Heinrich, and Grasch Bay that have 11-inch, as well as O-class as 11-inch, but none can hold 15-inch. So this will be exciting when we review her. And then we have Magdeburg, or I have renamed her Danzig, which is one of the most fun cruisers in the entire game. And like I said, I can't wait to go over these last few cruisers with you. But all in all, the entire German cruiser tech tree line is quite fun. It may seem struggling in the very first few tiers. You don't really get a good cruiser until Nürnberg. And some people may still struggle with that. But regardless, if you can go through the rest of the tiers, you may find that you might like this German cruiser line a bit more than you might like others. With that, I will wrap up today's video. If you like the video, make sure you like and subscribe for further content. And join me tomorrow while we go over Dresden. So again, thank you for watching and take care.